Aiden getting some exercise.
What? You got it worked out, haven't you? Aiden's doing what others can't.
Now Aiden's on a horse. Riding it. How much fun is this, hey?
To give you an idea of where we are, up there is Caltex. This is called the Royal Skyrunner. It's a cardiovascular workout device. So you put your feet on there and you run like crazy. Well, at least you try to. I have a real problem with this thing. Not that it's bad for you, I just have a real problem.
So this really is a test. I've got a lapel now, and it's interesting to see how it works in relationship to a little Pixel, Manfrotto Pixel that I use, and on my phone, as opposed to rather than using my Canon EOS M and a 22mm lens. But instead of that, I'm going to be using the phone a little bit more often to see how this works. And you know what? In a public location, sometimes this is actually the better option. So here's an interesting point of view, which has only occurred to me in the last few days, regarding people who now use their smartphones for vlogging. Vlogging meaning video logging, presenting them on the internet for anybody else to watch and enjoy and view. The interesting thing I've noticed about this whole concept is, well, let's just go back a step. About 2 years ago, we were over here, when we first started moving over to King Kangaroo Island, we happened to be at Emu Bay Beach, and I was walking up, there's a semaphore up towards the jetty along the pavement, or it could have been bitumen, and there I was with my EOS M and probably a smallish lens, and a different mini tripod. I'll put a picture of it just here, the death of it, and I happened to hold it up in the air like I am now to take a video of myself and the surrounding area around me, and these three women, we'll say middle-aged to elderly women, were walking off to one side of me, and they yelled out as loud as they felt comfortable yelling out, "Get a life." And you know, a little part of me went, "Oh yeah, get a life," as in they thought I was being a bit silly filming myself or taking selfies of myself. I presume they thought I was doing. But the fact of the matter is, I was doing a little video of the Emu Bay Beach, like any family would. Within the modern day, we've all got videography capability on our phones. We might have a 7D or one of the newer models, like I think there's a 60D, which has video capability and a little view screen out the back for seeing the end result on. And it could have been anybody just taking a video of their enjoyment here on Kangaroo Island. Yet these women felt the need to tell me that to get a life meant that, you know, I was doing something which was, presumably they thought it was, I don't know, you know, I'm guessing. I mean, maybe I'm putting words into their head, which really I'm thinking myself. But it's dawned on me that the video logging of our lives and the things around us and the things we enjoy and the places we go, there's nothing wrong with that. Yes, there's a little bit of a stigma to be seen holding your phone up in the air and having a microphone hanging off it. But if you think about it, there are reporters for radio stations, but newspapers and the news and the current affairs, they go out in the field with a camera and they video the world around them and show it off, like floods and fires and catastrophic and casual and corporate and, you know, events that are happening around them. And nobody says, "Hey man, got a life." Because maybe they're wearing a uniform or a suit and tie. It makes them look like they're meant to be doing that sort of work. Is there anything really wrong with the average person doing this sort of thing? No, I don't think so. Not anymore. But end of the day, I'm going to be doing this more and more. I'm going to be doing it at places like Chocolat, down the beaches, on the fields. Okay, I went off on a Winston Churchill tangent there. But I'm going to be taking my video camera around a bit more often. Yes, I've said that before and it hasn't happened. That's because I have a job and I have a life. I have a family and a wife. A poet, and I know it. So it doesn't happen as much as I'd like it to, but there is plans to do it more. And there I am, you can see me sitting down at home, enjoying taking a few videos and then showing you what I do. Now if you've been watching and you've been enjoying, you would have seen this video regarding the time I punctured my knee after a silly bicycle accident, or maybe this video showing a cuttlefish on the jetty and there's a dog licking it, and my kid enjoyed seeing that. There's even videos about me being a radio presenter, another image just here. But more importantly, right now I'm wiring picture frames that were used in my 2010 and 2016 Sala exhibition. I had 20 done, 40 by 50 centimeter frames with some of my best work, or some of my personal best work. Only about 4 of them sold at the time, so I've had 16 frames sitting around. Actually no, 10 of them went to the Catalyst Foundation in Adelaide and stayed there for about 2 years. That was the 2016 sale exhibition. I only just managed to get them at the end of 2018. I'm having them changed from a string to a wire, and I've had to teach myself, referring to a couple of videos on YouTube. It's not actually that hard. I've been putting it off for way too long. I've got 2 done so far and there's more to come. I'll put videos to each one just here if you haven't seen it already. Anyway, I hope you enjoy my videos. When you get a chance, if you're enjoying what you're seeing, and I certainly hope you are, I want you to hit that notifications button, the subscription button, and like this video. Otherwise, at the end here, you're going to see some of my merch, which I also sell. I've got t-shirts and mugs and cups and sweaters and hoodies and so forth, all available. Also is this t-shirt. This is my Radio 5 Kicks FM radio presenter t-shirt. I'll see you next time.